Well, now to a soldier's headstone in Cincinnati, and it's become the center of controversy. The marker is in the shape of a popular cartoon character. It was approved, so why has the cemetery now removed it? Here's NBC's Ron Mott with the story.
She was excited about SpongeBob, you know, but that was her love and her passion was SpongeBob.
Kimberly Walker's family remembers her as a caring young woman, someone always smiling.
She just, you know, had this love for SpongeBob, and I think it's because he was just such a jolly-go-lucky cartoon character.
So when the Army sergeant was murdered in February at age 28, her family spared no expense, ordering two SpongeBob SquarePants granite headstones, $26,000 for the pair, to honor Kimberly and her twin sister, who serves in the Navy. The family got approval for the 6-foot-8-inch tall, 3.5-ton monuments by this Cincinnati cemetery, final resting place of such American icons as the real-life Procter & Gamble. But a day after the headstones were erected this month, the Spring Grove Cemetery hauled them off.
It's just unreal. We just can't imagine.
The cemetery apologized, saying the family chose a design with the guidance of a Spring Grove employee who unfortunately made an error in judgment. The monument does not fit within Spring Grove Cemetery guidelines, was not approved by senior management, and cannot remain here.
But have to deal with something like this is atrocious.
Rare though the monuments may be, SpongeBob is actually on another headstone at another cemetery about an hour away, part of 5-year-old Camden Fairchild's lasting legacy.
We picked out the headstone and monument and size and everything before we even contacted the cemetery, and never had any friction.
Today, cemetery officials are scheduled to meet with the Walker family with hopes of reaching a compromise, saying they'll reimburse the family and pay for new monuments. Still, a grieving mom wants SpongeBob as is.
We want the SpongeBobs back, and that's the only thing we're going to settle for.
Set in stone, yet far from permanent. For today, Ron Mott, NBC News, Chicago.